So welcome to our third session of The Smith and Swan in What We Believe.
What You Believe, yeah.
What We Believe. So we are on our last point of God's image. Mm. And so, Murray, what does it say?
Yeah, thank you. So in our statement of faith, What We Believe at SUC, the first part of the sentence says, because God created all people equally in His image and Jesus gave His life to restore it, every person's life is sacred. So I think it takes us right back to Genesis again, Rob, this lovely idea that there's man and woman, male and female created in the image of God. There's a sense of dignity, respect, there's equality. Yeah. There's no sense of hierarchy there.
Yeah.
God is the supreme being and what is created is equal before Him, of an equal footing, which is the starting point, which I think is terribly encouraging for us in a world that is full of hierarchy, brokenness, power struggles that before God, although governments might not agree with us, society might not agree with us, but you and I as believers can say that before God we are equal and we have this equal footing, and in that, created in his image, comes His authority, His ownership, His love, His assurance. So what a place to start.
Yeah, and the we not just being male and male, the we being man and woman created equally with the same amount of importance before God.
Yes.
I know historically that has been an issue and currently is still a big issue of, you know, I'm greater than you, no, I'm greater than you, the battle of the sexes.
Yeah.
There's also the battle of my culture is better than your culture.
Absolutely.
My skin color is better than your skin color.
Yeah.
You know, I'm from this area, you from that area.
Yeah.
You know, you from Humewood, I'm from Summer Strand, you know.
We
battle with issues of equality.
We really do. And I think our nation is battling with it. You know, you're from the city, I'm from the town. You own land, I don't land. You're white, I'm black. You're male, you're female. Absolutely. I mean, I think you've hit on it. So this issue of equality is huge. I think Jesus struggled with it, eh?
Yeah.
He didn't struggle, His disciples did. You know, who's the greatest?
Yeah. Yeah. And when the kids came, they wanted to chase them away.
Yeah. It's an ancient struggle. So I think our belief statement clarifies that every life is sacred.
Yeah.
So we're not going to touch on it now, but that would include in our understanding that unborn child in a womb.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
a sacred life, yeah. sanctity of life. The statement goes on to say every person has a God-given dignity and the right to be treated with respect no matter their age, gender, culture, or social status. So I think Genesis being that starting point that we've mentioned, and then Jesus builds on that. And I think you've got a text that goes right through to Revelation, which creates a picture of one day.
So starting with what you brought in with Genesis, that everyone was created equally.
Yes.
Fast forwarding to when Jesus returns, and there's the renewing and creating of the world.
Yeah.
There is also equality.
Absolutely.
Before the throne, there, as Revelation chapter 7 verse 9 says, there's a great multitude that no one could number, from every nation, from all tribes and peoples and languages, stand before the throne and before the Lamb.
Yeah.
And so it's not that everyone will be there, but no matter the color,
yes,
no matter the culture, no matter the geography, no matter the economic level,
yes,
no matter the criminal level, no matter you can't have a level that disqualifies you from not potentially being before
absolutely. And so that we've said Jesus comes to restore that image of God.